in order to start, we'll put the attention on the breath for just a moment. I'd like you to think and consider how often in your daily life you have become aware of your own thinking process, and if you have become aware, how often you have noticed it to be negative. I'd like you to consider how often, when you notice the mind being negative, you have tried to substitute with the opposite, or whether you justified the negative thought. I'd like you to consider how often the mind has been rejecting or negative or bothered or irritated since you've come here to Green Gulch. Have you noticed it? Can you recapitulate how often it happened? And when it happened, did you try to substitute with a positive thought, or did you believe the negative one? If you believed the negative thought, did you act on it? Were you aware of the negative thought and acting upon it? Or was it just an automatic process triggered by some outer happening? Since you've come here to Green Gulch, have you become aware of your reactions or just taking them for granted and believing them? In your daily life, have you become aware of body actions, movements, intentional and involuntary? Have you tried to become aware of them? And if you've tried to become aware of bodily actions, has impermanence of each one of them entered your mind? And since you've come here, have you tried to become aware of the body's actions, intentional and involuntary? Have you noticed when you haven't been aware, haven't paid attention? Can you remember now what you did instead of paying attention to the body's actions. Have you noticed that when you do pay attention to body movement of whatever kind, that no problem can possibly arise? Have you noticed that? Have you noticed yourself being judgmental towards other people? Since coming here? And have you believed that? Or did you smile at yourself? Have you noticed that the mind gives the orders and that the body follows suit, sometimes better, sometimes worse? We had that experience. If you haven't had that experience, do it right now. Tell your left foot to move and realize who's in charge and who is the servant. Are you aware of the identification you have with your body? and the desire in the mind that the body should be comfortable at all times. Can you be aware of that? And have you noticed that the body can't comply with this desire? You noticed the mind reacting to any discomfort in the body? Or did you take it for granted that it should be so? Can you notice that you can only know that on which you put your mind? That everything else disappears. And can you translate that into your meditation experience? You only know that on which you put your mind. Have you noticed that when the meditation becomes distracted, that mindfulness is not present? that distraction is the opposing factor to mindfulness. Look at your daily life in terms of ordinary, everyday mindfulness. Try to bring up the occasions. Ordinary, everyday mindfulness is a supporting mental factor for what you do. And then have a look to see whether you have already used spiritual mindfulness in your daily life. Seeing those aspects of yourself which go beyond utility. Recapitulate in your mind those aspects of mindfulness which go beyond everyday consciousness. And see whether you can use them here in this course. See if you can remember what they are and how we can practice them. Can you see why distraction arises? Can you see the me consciousness behind the distraction? May people everywhere practice mindfulness for spiritual growth.